What's going on, everyone, and welcome to the RabidMining YouTube channel. And today I'm going to be putting together these two rigs that we did unbox the other day. Now, I'm not going to go through everything step for step. I have put multiple CPU mining rigs together in the past. If you want to know how to do it, you know, be sure to check out one of them build videos. But I am going to go through the parts where I do utilize the 24 pin splitters here, as well as splitting the CPU power between that, because we are only going to be using a single power supply, an ATX power supply in this case, for these two rigs. But first, I do got to get some room. So I'm going to take those two 3950Xs, probably move them over to a single power supply as well, and then throw brackets on them, then stack them up over in this corner. And then I'm going to have room right here where that second one is. You can see here the RAM did come in. I wasn't expecting that till sometime next week, so awesome. I don't have to use any of these extra sticks laying around here, so I'll be using one of those. And some PDU splitters actually came in as well, which is four CL14s, or maybe they're 13s, CL13s actually, to a CL14 PDU splitters, because you don't need a full cable per power supply. These things only use 95 to 100 watts, so you can easily get 800, 900, even 1,000 watts out of a single PDU cable, so a four splitter is just fine in this case. So first thing I do gotta do here is I gotta shut these off, and I really hate shutting off CPU mining rigs, but hey, I'm taking two offline so that four can go online, so you know it's worth it in this case. All right, guys, so an interesting turn of events happened. So as you can see, I got those two set up. They're no longer on their pegs. They're standing upright, two on each other, and I got the 24-pin splitter. Now, I was gonna split the CPU cable with this GPURisers PCI Express. I thought, here, let's zoom in there. You can see it, that's awesome right there. I do also have some GPURisers hard drives on these. You can see a little product placement, but these don't work. PCI Express, there are legitimately CPU splitters that I was not aware about, like we have here. So these are actually CPU splitters. The pin layouts, or I guess the shapes, are slightly different. Here you can see one square and the rest are all like that oval triangle, whatever the thing bottom at the flap here. I guess there's one square up here, but the ones we need to split, actually you need a square here and right across diagonal, a square right there, and the rest are all these. So these are actually not working. I put these in, turned it on, nothing would turn on. So then I did blow these out with air and stuff. I thought maybe I hit the CMOS button, but then I was like, okay, so what's the issue? I'm kind of lucky nothing lit on fire. But then I decided to try just the CPU pin itself, and it fired right up. And I went to Hive OS, it's all mining. So what I did in this case, I actually ran both CPU cables here. So on the back of the power supply, I'm trying to hold my phone flashlight here to give light here at the same time. But this power supply has two CPU cables. CPU one, what if I can get out of here for you guys? So you can see there, there's CPU two being used, and then underneath over here, let's kind of get in there. So CPU one, CPU two. So this has two CPU cables, and I just ran one to each of them and still utilizing that 24 pin, and everything fired right up and it seems to be working, at least for now. So I did go over to my other power supplies here. These ASUS Rogue Strix here that I did get mentioned earlier, we unboxed them. So I just gotta find the other side here. These actually are fairly heavy, so they're pretty decent power supplies as long as they didn't just throw some weights in there to make it seem like it's decent. But we can see that says CPU, VGA, and PCI Express, and then CPU, VGA, PCI Express. So they got a multiple CPU pins, and we can use the same rails here by the looks of things as their PCI Express or VGAs, is how they're labeling it. But that's what we can do. So hopefully I got two CPU cables inside this box, and then I can just do the same thing when I do build those two rigs there. At least for now, I do plan on actually ordering the proper splitters in the future, and maybe I'll talk to GPURisers.com because I was unaware of it, but maybe they can get some of these splitters made and they can sell them on their website, because I think that'd be cool. I'm using them pretty much everywhere and I was not even aware that there are specific CPU splitters for this case. Okay, so I did go through this bag of all the cables here, and I did find, obviously, we got our 24 pin here, check. And then we got a CPU cable that says PSU on it right there. Where is it? Of course you're gonna do this to me now. You're hiding on me. Just kind of move this over. There, we got CPU here, throw that over there, and another one, PSU. Oh, we're doing it again. Failing. Oh, you saw the C there. So we do have two CPU cables, and that's why another reason why I love using M2 drives, and they're so cheap right now, that this is all the cables you need. Your 24 pin, and then normally it'd just be your single CPU cable, but we're gonna use two in this case, so it looks like we're good to go. The build is back on. All right, so I do have everything pretty much together here. Next step is I am gonna have to take this GPU right here, put it into here, fire each one up one by one, set up the BIOS, because I already flashed HiveOS and everything into these M2 drives. And then once I get them all able to turn on by themselves, just through their power restarts and then BIOS settings, so that they boot up and have the settings I want them to be at with their all core overclocks and voltages, I will do another video sometime soon on setting up the BIOS for CPU mining for you guys. But until then, I know I'm not going to display it in. I have previous ones that kind of go through it, but I'll do a nice how-to here sometime close in the future. But yeah, I'm going to get these things ready, and then they will be set up to start using that splitter and everything, and I'll go through that process with you guys. Well, so far one rig looks like it's working. I'm just going to go through how I have this set up. So I have my HodgePodge GPU here, which is running off a riser, which plugs into the x16 slot. Then I got my capture card coming in, I can see it over there, coming into the GPU here. We got a different power supply, and then a splitter powering this to a splitter, and then another 6-pin going into the riser. So I just carry this around. It's an old 2 GB GPU, an RTX, I don't even know what, a 670 or something. It's old school, Gigabyte, 3 fans. And that's all I use this thing for, is to set up these motherboards and then I get rid of it. So I just wanted to show you how I quickly do this. All right, guys, so everything is pretty much ready to roll. I got the BIOS and everything set up. So now I gotta implement this 24-pin splitter. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna plug in the two 24-pin ends into each one of these motherboards. Then I'm gonna get the power supply in and simply plug that 24-pin into the female end right here, which should then provide power to the motherboards of both of these two rigs. Okay, so now we can kind of see I got the 24-pin in the first motherboard, as well as the other one in the back here, and nothing plugged into the female end. So I'm gonna get the power supply just kind of tucked in behind here, kind of like what I have going on right here. We'll get a closer look at that in a second. But everything does look set up. Once the power supply is in, then I will string out the two CPU cables and we'll turn it on and hopefully it fires up. Just kind of touching up on what I was mentioning there about the power supply in the back. So this is the other rig, and you can kind of see how I have the power supply kind of tucked in behind here. So that's what I'm gonna do back here as well. Get those a little closer together. But yeah, I'm just gonna get the power supply in and we'll see what happens. All right, guys, so we are at the moment of truth. So I have everything plugged in here. Oh, we got our Ethernet cables, power supply. We got the PDU cable coming in around the back here. So we're gonna go the other side, turn on the power supply, and hopefully nothing sparks. So it is a little dark. I'm about to turn this on, but I just kind of show you what I got going on. So as we know, whoa, that's a bright light there. So right there is where I am plugged in to the 24 pin going into the splitter right there. I got the two CPU cables coming out. One's coming out and into it on this side here, and then the other one's coming out the front and into the other one. So now all I got to do, if this thing focuses, is turn on the power button, which is right here. Are we ready? Moment of truth. I got the 0 dB fan turned off. I want this to do whatever it's got to do in order to stay cool. Fan noise is not an issue here, so let's go on. All right, I got lights. I heard a click. Fan is spinning there. I got that cooler is on. I got to run to the other side now and see if the other one's on. Yes, it is. Nice. So we got power. This thing is on and working there. Back one here is working right there, so I can kind of space these out. I kind of like this way a little bit better, as long as all the PSUs you use does have individual cables and slots for CPUs, because with the splitters, I actually have to have them really tight, close together. You can see right here, there isn't really much room here, but you know, we're running efficiently. This is just fine to keep these things cool. They only run around 50 degrees packed into, you know, confined spaces like this. As you can see over there, all these are kind of like that and so on. So you don't need much in terms of cooling when you are CPU mining. So anyone going out there and wasting money on AIOs, that's a bad idea. And it's not really recommended for CPU mining anywhere. I really believe air is cheaper and it works better for mining 24/7. AIOs are not designed for 24/7 use. It's to hit those peak voltages at certain times to move it and cool that CPU fast. But over time, AIOs will gradually start heating up the temperature within the water, and then you'll just run into overheating problems. Now obviously you're probably going to reset your rig, you know, once a week, once a month, something, so you may not hit that issue. But if you try to go for like a 2-year straight hiatus without a rig going down, you're probably going to start overheating something because that water will just get too warm. Ambient temperatures also has a lot to do with it, but so far everything's looking good. I'm going to run to HiveOS and see if we're actually detected. Okay, so it looks like rig 17 and 18, actually this is rig 18 and 19, are up and running for my CPU. So this camera kind of sucks when it comes to focusing here, but it's just a quick visual that yes, we are in HiveOS and we are detected. All right guys, so everything is looking good now. So if you have any questions or comments, let me know down below. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.